Papa, why are there so many poor in Egypt? Yet those who don't belong here are rich.
Egypt has forgotten who she is. Many chose wealth over honor. In the end, they got neither. And lost justice as well.
But we are Magi. We will bring justice and honor back to Egypt.
Yes, my son. We have not forgotten who we are. We will endure, no matter our origin. Amun, the king of gods, divided in two forms, as the great goddess of invisibility, Amunet, and master of the wind. He upholds justice, lord of the shadows and the silence. He comes at the voice of the poor. He hears the confessions of the humble and forgives them.
Papa, what is best in life?
To seek justice and truth. To live with honor. To protect the weak and the poor. And to love your mother.
My friend Kenan said it was to crush our enemies and to hear the lamentations of their women.
We are Magi, son, not barbarians. Apis, the bull god. He is the strength of the pharaoh. Each year, he is born as a calf with special markings. The pharaoh finds this calf and worships it. Magi have a duty to the gods. We must be strong and ready to fight. But we must only fight when it is just.
I'll practice hard, Papa. I want to be strong and hunt like you do.
You are already better with your weapons than many men. You will make a fine Magi, son.
Like Mom says, may your victories multiply.
The Divine Lion, the powerful one. Her breath formed the desert, the fiercest of hunters. She leads the armies of the Pharaoh into battle. Hey, have you talked to this girl you like?
I didn't say I liked her. We were friends, but she's being strange and avoiding me.
Maybe because she likes you too. We often do not say what we mean. It will come to you in bursts.
Why would she avoid me if she likes me?
This is something your mother should explain. I am better with the stars. The goldfish, called Capricornus by the Greeks. The god has the head of a ram and the body of a fish. You see? Even the gods do not always make sense.
Papa, when you met Mother, how did you know she liked you?
My heart lit on fire, of course. She smiled at me, and her eyes rendered me helpless.
So if a girl likes you, she smiles at you?
Son, there are some things I can explain to you. The stars, how to fight. But this is something not even the gods can tell. You will have to ask a goddess. Hathor, goddess of motherhood and joy. She is loved by all in Egypt, from the least to the greatest, mistress of the West. She welcomes the dead to the afterlife. That is Horus, the Falcon, the Great Black One, God of the Sky. The Sun is his right eye, and the Moon is his left eye. Forever he flies across the heavens, making night and day.
The Eye of Horus is what the Magi wear?
Yes, Remu.
And the Pharaoh is Horus, right?
Yes, my son. The Pharaoh is Horus in life, and Osiris in death. That is why the Pharaoh rules not only Egypt, but the whole world. Only a true Pharaoh, though. Osiris was cut into 14 pieces by his jealous brother, who scattered the pieces throughout the land. Osiris' wife, Iset, searched and found all the pieces except one.
What happened to the other piece?
It was eaten by a fish. It was his... So Osiris was resurrected and became Lord of the Underworld.
Oh, so we couldn't have children anymore, huh?
You are growing up far too quickly. Osiris, the father of gods, brother of Seth, who murdered him. It is said that Iset's tears for her beloved husband created the Nile.
Papa, why do people die?
We are not gods. Everything must die. It is what Amun has ordained for us.
Will we be together in the afterlife?
Be brave and strong. Fight for justice. Do not lie. This is all anyone can do. Ma'at will decide if we are worthy to walk together in the field of reeds. I'm sure you will, though. Your car is good. Pisces, the two fish. Joined by the thread of this life, they are forever balanced between the afterlife and the underworld.
Papa, how do you know if you're in love?
Why, Chemu? Do you think you are in love?
I don't know. Love should feel good. You and Mom are the only ones I love. But this hurts. Sometimes I can't even think straight.
That sounds like love. It could be. I was once like that. I'm very sorry, son. The scorpion goddess Serket. She protected Iset and Horus from jealous Set. She still protects against poisonous animals. But not love. Against that, there is no protection. Not even the gods can.
Papa, do you think I'll have many children?
Hey, I hope you give your mother and I many grandchildren.
I'll have to find a wife then.
You are young, my son. There's no reason to rush.
I won't rush. But what if I already know?
You need to learn how to be a Magi first. Oh, Tawaret. The hippopotamus who walks. Lady of the birth house. She is the goddess of fertility and childbirth. Mistress of the horizon. She brings with her the yearly flood of Ar.
Papa, you know how you're Egyptian and mother is Greek. What if Egypt and Greece go to war?
Greeks and Egyptians do not hate each other. We are all the same.
It feels like they do. A priest in the temple school said Greeks were destroying Egypt.
He was wrong to say that. There is good and bad in everyone. You are the child of both Egypt and Greece. You are proof they do not hate each other. Ah, the great twins. To the Greeks, they are twin brothers. To Egyptians, they are he-goats that rise from the underworld, bringing pestilence and protection. Even the gods have two sides. Those are the scales, called Khonsu. When we die, the goddess Ma'at weighs our hearts on them, against her white feather.
I remember this. If our hearts appear in light, we walk in the field of reeds.
Very good. You were listening. The scales measure truth and justice, which is why Magi pursue these two things above all others. Your name, Khemu, means Egypt. Like Egypt, you are forever changed.